I know you like nothing more than a number with a name. So we're going to do witness numbers. They can provide witness for your good character, or more specifically, they provide a witness for if a number is prime or not. And there's nothing we enjoy more in mathematics than working out if a number is prime or not.
I'm curious to know whether 747 is prime.
Ooh, that's lovely. If you add the digits together, it's 18. So, spoiler, it's not prime. Oh. It's going to be a multiple of 9. But, let's say we don't know that. Is 747 prime? Well, here's what we're going to do. We're going to call up a witness to testify on behalf of 747 to say whether or not it's prime. And you can choose your witness. It's any number smaller than 747. So from now on, this is like our N. This is the number we're interested in. What witness would you like to call to represent your number?
I'd like to call the number 23.
23, nice. So A is gonna be our witness 23. I'm using the standard letters in case people wanna research this afterwards. You've called witness 23. So first of all, we gotta prepare your N for trial. We wanna rearrange it to be powers of 2. So some, I don't know what number we're gonna have up here. There's gonna be some number M, which will be how many 2s there are. And then that's multiplied by some other number. And then because, okay, we're assuming this is odd. This works for odd n greater than 2. And if it's not an odd n greater than 2, it's pretty obvious if it's prime or not. So we don't worry about that. So this is definitely going to be odd, and that's going to give us something even, because we're multiplying by a whole bunch of 2s, plus 1. So this is the form we want to put our number in just to get it ready. It's like putting on a suit and a tie when you go to court. So actually, you know what? Let's get a calculator. I'm trying to minimize the mistakes this time.
Minimize the mistakes.
Not eradicate, just... You know, I'm trying to cut back. Okay, so we got 740. We're gonna take one off, so that's gonna be 6. And I'm just gonna see if I can divide it by 2. I can. 2 goes into it once. Is that it? That's it. Okay, right, cool. Well, that'll be easy. So that's gonna be 2 to the power of 1 times 373. So now our M is 1 and our D, the leftover chunk, is 373. So what you're doing is you're going, let's pretend it's a power of 2, but then we gotta multiply it by something and add 1 to act, because it's not actually a power of 2. But this is, if it was, that's, you know, what it would be. Okay, so now we're gonna ask, right, A, is A to the power of whatever this D is, does that equal 1 mod N? That's our question, very simple question. And it's either gonna say yes or no. And so let's find out, shall we? So we gotta do, 23 to the power of 300, terrible choice, Brady.
Sorry.
I hate to be retrospectively critical of your choice. Oh my goodness. Now, computationally, it's not that bad because of this mod. So if I said, what's 23 to the power of 373? It would be a nightmare because that's going to be like an outrageously big number. But because we can mod it by n each time, we're never going to have a number at any point that's bigger than 747. So each time we multiply 23 by 23 by 23 by 23, we just keep modding by 747. I'm going to cheat and ask Wolfram Alpha. Sorry about that.
Yeah.
747. Okay, Wolfram Alpha that, and we did 23 to the power of 373 mod 747, and it was 131. Now, this is not one. It's got some ones in it, but that's not what we're after. In this case, the first witness has come up and said, nah, not prime. And if a single witness says, not prime, not prime. That's it. The number is kicked out of the court, or whatever this, the prime test place. They are turfed out, they are not a prime number the moment a witness says no.
So this is foolproof, Matt. If we get 1, we can take it to the bank.
No. So, this is how it works. If a witness says not prime, you can totally believe them. That no witness is ever gonna lie and say it's not prime and it actually is. However, some witnesses will lie and say it's prime when it's not. So you'll never get a false negative. You will occasionally get a false positive. So not all witnesses are reliable when they say yes. And they're literally called liars. They're called strong liars because they give an absolute, they're like definitely 100% that number's prime. You have to believe me. And they're lying.
A non-one we can trust, you fail.
Yep. Yep.
But a 1 isn't an absolute guarantee.
No, not an absolute guarantee. I'll tell you what, let me do another one and I'll show you a liar in action. So same style as before, but this time our number, again, it's not a prime. So we're going to do n equals 91. Not a prime number. We're going to call a witness. We're going to call the number 10. Maybe, all right, 10, get in here. We want to hear all about 91. Well, first of all, we got to get them all dressed up for court. And so that's going to be our plus one at the end. It's going to leave us with 90. So we're going to have 2 to the 1 times 45. So our D value is 45. Okay, so we get A, and we're like, rightio A, 10 to the power of 45, which is going to be a very big number. What does that equal if we're going mod 91? So, having a good old-fashioned think, giving us 90. Now, first of all, you're thinking, hang on, failed the test. However, interestingly, 90 is negative 1, mod 91, because it's 1 below. And so actually, we will accept positive or negative 1.
All right, so that should be a pass, actually, then.
Yeah, so it's passed. So 10's like, nah, checks out, love it. Put it in the mix. And you're like, okay, do we trust 10? Let's say we picked a number below 91 at random, and the number says, yep, it's prime. And you're like, well, I don't know how much I trust it. Should we check another one? Well, I happen to know, below 91, there are 90 numbers. So there's 90 possible witnesses we could call. Of those, 18 of them are liars. So there's an 18 out of 90 chance that when we picked a number at random, I happen to know 10 was a liar, it's going to be a liar. And so now you're like, well, hang on, how does this help? And so sadly at the moment, what we have is a probabilistic primality test. So it's an absolute composite number test. If it says it's composite, it is. If it says it's prime, you're like, I don't know. Now, if every number, you're like, forget it. Bring all 90 possible witnesses in here. If all 90 of them are like, nah, it's definitely prime, then it's definitely prime.
So you can't have all liars.
You can't have all liars. So 18 is just below a quarter of 90. This is one of the worst cases. But for any number, maximum a quarter of the possible witnesses will be liars. And so now you can just keep calling up witnesses at random, and it has to be at random, that are smaller than the number you're testing. And each time you test it, worst case, there's a 1 in 4 chance. And so what you can say is, if you do K tests and you're picking properly at random, if they all say it's prime, K times, then there's a 1/4 to the K chance worst case. This is now we're talking about probabilities of probabilities, because it's below this, that's like your worst case. So it's that or better. So what you do is you're like, well, you know what? If I want to be 99.9% sure, you just do enough tests to get you past that limit. And so because computationally, doing multiplications and mods, computers are very happy with that. Oh, and the one extra thing you can do is a witness can request that, as well as just having this D at the front, it can have any extra multiples of 2 out the front, but not as many as the original breakdown. So here we had a 2, here we had 1, 2. If this had been something like 2 cubed or 2 to the 4, then you could put in a bunch of 2s here, and if any of them give you a 1 or a negative 1, then that's a yes. So you've got to check a few things. All of them are very fast for computers to do. And so when you go to one of these websites, is this number prime? And it's like, pretty sure it's prime. What it's doing is it's doing a test like this, often this exact test. And it's using that to just be able to say with some level of confidence, yeah, we're pretty sure that's prime.
In the case of 91,
yep.
10 is a liar.
10's a liar.
Along with 17 other numbers, you said.
Correct.
Is there a number that is notorious for being a liar more often than other numbers?
You know, you were so close. The opposite. There are star witnesses. There are some witnesses where if you're going to pick anyone, this is the A team of witnesses you want to call upon. In fact, they're so good that you don't even have to call any non-star witnesses. So I said you could just check all the numbers. In fact, for any number below a trillion, there's a squad of 4 witnesses. And if you ask all 4 of them and they all sign off on it, you're guaranteed. Let's meet them. Here we go.
But my word, yes.
I know.
These are celebrities.
These are there. These are, okay, let's get some more paper. I should also say that this is called the Miller-Rabin. test. And you can do the probabilistic version, or you call out your star witnesses, and then you know. So if your only witnesses are 2 and 3, if they cosign and say, nah, great number, definitely a prime, that will work for any number up to 1,373,653. Any number below that, if you just ask 2 and 3, you're good. Now that is a speedy primality test. Interestingly, you'll have no idea what the prime factors are of this number. And I'm fascinated by prime tests where you don't divide and you don't even know what the factors are. You just know they exist. I find that so interesting.
But at that point, for that number there,
yep,
one of those two will lie.
Yeah, one of them cracks. I don't know what this number did to one of these, but there's been some witness tampering going on, and they've now got... They're now upset. So what you do is you bring in another witness. You're like, okay, from now on, we're doing 2, we're doing 3, and we're doing 5. Very primey. Get to that in a moment. Now, 5, not only does 5 sort out this one, 5 gets you all the way up to 25 million. Specifically 25,326,001. So it'll break on this number. So it works all the way up to 1,000 flat. And so by bringing in one extra star, now you've got 3-star witnesses, you're doing all right. That said, we could have in here, like, let's say we're so disappointed that these witnesses let us down. These folks were unreliable for this number. We're like, get out of here. You know what? We're going to replace you with A equals 31 or 73. I mean, bigger, chunkier numbers. But if you just use these two as witnesses, that works all the way up to 9,080,191. Better star witnesses. If you only got space for 2, then I would recommend bringing in 31 and 73. They make a bit more mess. They're not as well behaved as 2 and 3, but they will get you, you know, over 8 times as far.
They're hostile witnesses, but they're honest.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. They get it done. People may not approve of their methods. Get the job done.
All right.
And then before, I said the squad of 4. So this is, if you bring in... And like, this is like for a really important case. You're like, you know what? We cannot mess around. And these folks were only discovered in 1993.
These are expert witnesses.
These are expert. Like, this is the A-team. 2. Classic 2. Forget 3, though. You want to bring in 13. You want to bring in 23. And then the team captain, 1,662,803. They're a real maverick. so not good to work with. There've been many times I've had to hand in their badge, all that, but they will crack the hardest of holdouts. So these guys will get you, these are the guys who get you over a quadrillion. So
this is like a good cop, bad cop.
Oh, this is good, yeah, good cop, bad cop, gets results. These get you all the way up to, oh my goodness, 1 quadrillion, 122 trillion, 4 million, 669,633. So good reach. They don't mess around.
All right, Matt, you've shown me the star witnesses, but you still haven't told me who are the liars.
You know, I don't know. It had not occurred to me to look up who are the least reliable. And so, I mean, you could do it. You just have to, if someone wants to write some code and put the answer in the comments below, I think it'd be very interesting. You just have to go through every single number, find out how many strong liars it's got when you put it through the Miller-Rabin test, score each number for how often it shows up as a liar. And then we'll know who the most dishonest numbers are. These are the honest numbers. Oh, by the way, if this proves to be too much, you can actually replace them with 2 friendlier numbers. You can switch to 2, 3, 5, 7, 11. I mean, you're back to the primes. So actually, runs of primes are really good. They get you all the way up to 2,152,302,898,747. There you are. That's put a little bow on this video, hasn't it? Yeah, so it depends if you'd rather have fewer but unruly witnesses, or you're prepared, you've got like a fifth chair, and you can bring in 7 and 11 to do the lifting, so.
Oh, what you need to do is you need to find out what the 12 best are and call them the 12, you know, 12.
12 good numbers.
You can't handle the truth.
Oh. 12 angry numbers.
I'm guilty.
I bet there is a 12. Hang on. So if you want, I put them in red for being angry. So here's your... They don't take any malarkey from anyone. You're bringing in two. You're bringing in three, five. Oh, it's just the prime. 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29, 31, and 37. Just off the top of my head, that will get you up to 318 sextillion, I assume. 665 quintillion, 857 quadrillion. I'm just gonna write the numbers out. Or approximately 10 to the 23. That's the kind of order of magnitude you're looking at.
You'd have to use all 12.
You gotta use all, if they all has to be, you can't have a hung jury. It's, you gotta have completely unanimous. They've all gotta be like, yep. And in unison as a team, if they all say yes, they're right.
Whether it's prime numbers, composite numbers, or almost anything else, why not sharpen your skills with the amazing array of courses on Brilliant, today's episode sponsor. For a deeper understanding of how things work, you just can't beat interactivity. And that is Brilliant's stock and trade, as you can see. I can't really decide if this is recreation or education. I guess it's both. I recommend you check out Brilliant, and if you're already signed up, why not consider giving Brilliant as a gift to someone else? That inquisitive nephew, maybe. Or how about that auntie who's always been a lifelong learner? There's plenty of free stuff on the site, but Brilliant are offering a 20% discount on their all-inclusive premium package by using the URL brilliant.org/numberphile. It's there on the screen and in the description. Give them a look. Brilliant, they're great people, and they're making amazing stuff.